Good morning, friends, and welcome to all of you on this 16th Sunday after Pentecost. It is a joy to be God's people, whether we are gathered here in this space or worshiping from home. Remember that no matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, that you are welcome here at St. Paul United Church of Christ in Wapakoneta, Ohio. I do have just a few announcements to share this morning. A reminder that we are still actively looking for a church custodian. We have, as the church council has hired Amy Zuez on a temporary basis, and so she is filling in until we find a permanent custodian. So if you are interested in that position, please contact the church office for more information. Our Takeout Tuesday meal continues to grow. My understanding is that this Tuesday we served just shy of 300 meals, all in the span of what, an hour? People picking them up curbside. So thank you to those of you who have volunteered for that effort. There is certainly a need, and we continue to need volunteers for that effort. So if you are able to help, please let us know. You can contact either Tammy Zuez or Mark Vaughn for more information about how you can help with that effort. Speaking of food and such, we will be helping to host another large-scale food distribution through West Ohio Food Bank with the help of the Ohio Army National Guard. That food distribution event will take place on Wednesday, September 30th, at the Auglaize County Fairgrounds. So that's a change of location from the previous distributions. We will be at the fairgrounds, probably near the Junior Fair Building, on Wednesday, September 30th. The distribution will be from 1 to 3 p.m., as the previous ones have, with registration beginning about noon. So I could use volunteers to help with that effort as well. I'll be putting the word out soon. But mark your calendars, and if you can help that day, please let me know. I will be leading an upcoming adult study on Zoom online. That study will begin this Thursday, the 24th of September, and its title is Exercising Our Spiritual Muscles. So in order to attend, you need to receive a link in your email, so please let me know. We just have a few people signed up right now. Let me know by Tuesday so I can be sure to get that link out to you if you would like to participate. Karen Joseph is off today, and so Martha, thank you for doing, you know, the whole deal this morning. It's always a joy to have you at the organ. Janet Winkler is home from the hospital, and so we give thanks to God, and we pray for her continued healing. So I'm sure she would appreciate all of our prayers. As of today, there isn't anyone hospitalized that I know of. So remember, if you know of somebody who is hospitalized, please let me know or let the church office know. I would rather hear 10 times what's going on with folks than not know. So please let us know. I would ask that we continue to hold in prayer all of those who are on our prayer list, and remembering also that there are so many others who need our prayers who have gone unnamed. Are there other announcements to share this morning? The peace of Christ be with you. Please remain seated as we join responsively in our call to worship based on Psalm 105. O give thanks to the Lord, call on God's name, make known God's deeds among the peoples. We raise our voices, we bring our praises, telling of all God's wonderful works. Glory in God's holy name. Let all the hearts of those who seek God rejoice. We come seeking the Lord, relying on God's strength. May we always look toward God as our power and refuge. Let us pray together. Loving God, you provide us with all that we need, but we confess that we are often hungry for more. Teach us to discern our wants from our needs. Give us hearts full of compassion, ready to share with our neighbors. Help us always to live in your righteousness. Let us begin anew here today as we hear your word again and seek to follow in your way. Amen. Amen. Our scripture lesson for today comes from the Gospel according to Matthew. I'll be reading today from Matthew's Gospel, the 20th chapter, verses 1 through 16. Jesus said, "For the kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out early in the morning to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with the laborers for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. When he went out about 9 o'clock, he saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and he said to them, "You also go into the vineyard, and I will pay you whatever is right." So they went. When he went out again about noon and about 3 o'clock, he did the same. And about 5 o'clock, he went out and found others standing around, and he said to them, "Why are you standing here idle all day?" They said to him, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You also go into the vineyard." When evening came, the owner of the vineyard said to his manager, "Call the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and then going to the first." When those hired about 5 o'clock came, each of them received the usual daily wage. Now, when the first came, they thought they would receive more, but each of them also received the usual daily wage. And when they received it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last worked only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us who have borne the burden of the day and the scorching heat." But he replied to one of them, "Friend, I am doing you no wrong. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what belongs to you and go. I choose to give to this last the same as I give to you. Am I not allowed to do what I choose with what belongs to me? Or are you envious because I am generous?" So the last will be first, and the first will be last. This is God's word, given for us and for all of God's people. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Holy God, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be found acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. There is a simple sentence, three little words that children are known for saying freely. I love you, perhaps? Maybe. But perhaps just as often, it's not fair. Right? It's not fair. Now, perhaps as adults, we learn to quiet that voice. But maybe it's still inside there, right? And we say inside of ourselves, we say in our hearts, perhaps more often than we would like to admit, it's not fair. Jesus tells this parable of the generous landowner. And I'll have to admit that for many of us, I think it's still a difficult one. Because it doesn't seem fair, does it? That those who worked all day receive the same wage as those who were called to work only for an hour. When I was a child hearing this story, I remember thinking how strange it was to think about an employer just going to the middle of town and finding people and saying, "Hey, you want to come and work?" That's just not the way it works here in our society. However, it is the way it works still in some societies. This story made a whole lot more sense to me when I traveled to Namibia on my seminary cross-cultural trip, because that is exactly what happens there. I had never seen anything like it before. There are not enough jobs for the people. I mean, we talk about there not being enough jobs for the people in our own society, but the reality is that most individuals in our society are gainfully employed. Most people in our society have a job that they know they're going to go to, if not today, then sometime in the next week. Now, I'm not saying that everything's hunky-dory in our society, but, you know, this is the way we're used to seeing things work. When I traveled to Namibia, there simply aren't jobs. They don't exist. And the men really would gather in certain locations around the center of the city, and they would just stand there. They would stand there all day if they had to, hoping that someone would come by and be ready to hire them. You would see them in you know, filling up whole areas of the downtown. And there were three or four of these locations in the downtown of Windhoek, which was the capital city, where they would gather. And every so often, somebody driving a truck who was working on a construction project or something would say, you know, hey, I need 30 men, and point to the ones he wanted, and they would all climb into the back of the truck and stand there, and off the truck would go to wherever they were going to work that day. So this is the kind of society that Jesus was living in, where most people might not have known how they were going to feed their family that day. In this story, we find a generous master, a generous landowner who understands that it wasn't the fault of the workers that they didn't have enough, that those who were willing and able to work in the mind of this landowner deserved to bring home enough to take care of their family for that day. Reminds me of what we pray when we pray the Lord's Prayer. Give us this day our daily bread. That's how so many people in that society lived. They lived day to day. Give us enough just for today. So, we have this question that we wrestle with still. Is it fair? Is it fair? And those in the parable who showed up at the beginning of the day, who were called to work at the beginning of the day, that's the question they were asking. Is it fair? And the landowner turns that around and said, isn't it what we agreed upon? Isn't it what you said would be enough? Is it enough? There are implications, perhaps, from this parable about our physical monetary economy, but I want to focus today on our spiritual economy. Our spiritual economy. To ask, when is, in fact, enough enough? Is enough enough for us? It is an important question because it determines whether we are going to live from an attitude of abundance or not. Many of us have not learned how, or we do it in fits and starts, right? Sometimes enough is enough, and sometimes we just look around and think, come on, Come on. It doesn't seem fair. This idea of enough. In our society, but not just our society, I think many societies all over the world, you know, we measure our abundance, whatever it is, abundance of wealth or abundance of talent or abundance of social stature or anything else. We do so often in comparison to others. We don't just want enough for ourselves. We want more than the next guy, right? And it is hard. It is hard to stay focused on abundance rather than what we are still lacking. Jesus is suggesting that in the spiritual economy that he envisions for us, that we would learn to live lives out of gratitude. Gratitude for the abundance of blessing that we have in our lives. Gratitude. To live from a position of gratitude rather than a position of envy. And here's the kicker. We can't do both. It is one or the other. Gratitude or envy. Jesus has shown us the way. He has told us that enough is enough. Thanks be to God. Amen. God, most gracious, most generous, you pour your blessings upon us, your children. You have loved us with a love that is truer than we can imagine. And you have called us. You have called us from the marketplaces of our lives to labor in your vineyard. We pray that we might give what we have with open and grateful hearts, grateful for the love and the many blessings that you have given us. Help us to see and to realize the abundance in our lives, recognizing that we have all been gifted in varied ways. Not everyone counts their blessings the same, but we are all blessed. Blessed to be called your own. Help us to open our hearts toward one another and toward you, that we might let go of the envy, that we might let go of judging our own success over and against others, that we might instead live from a place of true abundance and gratitude for what you have given. We ask all of this in the name of the one who calls us to be disciples in his name, Jesus the Christ, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. And now let us go forth into the world in peace. Be of good courage. Hold fast to that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Honor all people. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all, now and forever. Amen. Blessings, everyone. Have a wonderful week.
For questions, concerns, and feedback regarding our live broadcast today, feel free to email us at livestreamstpauluccc@gmail.com.
Thank you for joining us today. If you would like to support the ministries of St. Paul UCC, you can do so in three ways. You can give on our website, www.stpauluccc.com. You can give by mail, by mailing your offering to P.O. Box 147, Wapakoneta, Ohio 45895. Or you can text the amount that you would like to give to 844-971-1800. Thank you. Sunday. No matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here at St. Paul United Church of Christ in Wapakoneta, Ohio.